So yeah, so that's it. You've seen the thumbnail, and you've seen that we're now rocking a Toyota Hilux. Good old Percy, he was a good old van, but we needed to upgrade. We needed a tow bar and we needed four seats, which will come in very handy. So let's take this somewhere else so we can have a good look around it, shall we? Ah! So let's have a look around him. Haven't got a name for him yet. What do you reckon I should call him? I'm thinking something extravagant. I haven't thought of it yet. So, 12-year-old truck. It's not without its dents and dings and scrapes and whatever. Nothing that's worrying me though. As you can see down there, it's all been schultzed and undersealed. And I'm not sure quite, well, you just don't know, do you? Whether they've done it in the same way I would have done it, by rust converting it or not, I don't know. So we may have to scrape a bit off and see. So we've got quite nice step things there, step extensions. Looking good. More under seal. I mean, this looks fine. It looks like it's back to some sort of metal and sprayed over. Now this side, we have a mud flap that looks like it's maybe an aftermarket option. I think we're gonna take that off because we haven't got one this side, or look for a pair. Don't know yet. Right, let's have a look at the back. Very nice. Right, we'll come back to this quarter in a moment. Part of the front. Got a few scratches, a few scrapes down there. We'll buff it up, I'm not too worried about those bits. And then we come to this quarter. This is the only bit of metalwork that's dented and scraped and scratched. And you can see someone's fixed it there. All this is fine, that'll buff out. This is the only thing. If that would buff out, then it'd be absolutely fine, and I think it will. He did offer to fix that for me for 300 quid, but nah, we'll keep the 300 quid. And it's got a bit of a ding in there where someone's obviously reversed into something. It would be nice just to push that out a little bit. The rear is really nice and spacious, which is brilliant because it's going to be used in part on the school run. It gives me a nice bit of flexibility now. Now that Freddie has got a roll cage in and Dennis's future is to be decided, I can do the school run in this no problem, which is brilliant. So for a spark, choosing a Hilux over a Peugeot partner van, which was perfectly serviceable and a very good van. Why? Why did I go for this? Well, we have proper four-wheel drive. Not that an electrician needs four-wheel drive. We have tow bar, which gives me a lot of options in the future. And we have the crew cab, four seats. So this brilliant space in the back here is going to take some thinking about. There's loads of space, but I've got to get the way I use it right. So I'm thinking some sort of van vault drawer, one side maybe, and then something like a pull-out tray that you see this side. So I just pull everything out. And then something over the top. So all this is hidden inside whatever we put here. And then the top I can use for bigger items that I need to sling in. Don't particularly like side windows. I'd have preferred a canopy without side windows. We need to think about something with them. We may even get rid of them and put a great big sheet of Ali in there and spray it black. And a little reversing camera so we can see what we're backing up to. Fantastic. Tire wise, we seem to be relatively new, to be fair. Look at that, that looks all right. And this looks virtually brand new. And this time it even came with my favorite thing in the world, rubber floor mats. So now we're back. There's a few additions I'd like to make, just to make the interior a bit more habitable and protected from me, because I'm very grubby. So the first thing we need is seat covers, front and back. Excellent. That should do the trick. The kids hate seat covers, but let's keep those seats nice, don't we? Nice. Get the dogs in the back now, look. Now, I've already done one of these, but I bought two, so we'll see what it's like in a week or two. We may use this one. This was cheaper than the Meguiar's alternative, and it's actually not too bad a smell. This was about $5.99. The Meguiar's one, I've used before, something like 14 quid or something. Then I'm going to need a pair of my go-to sunglasses. DeWalt, obviously. That one? Yeah, why not? And the last thing we need is a roof rack for over the cab. Right, this is what we've got. It says the maximum load it can take is 75 kilograms, which should be fine. We get a pipe tube on there, and we'll get the occasional set of ladders on there. I couldn't find it. I don't know whether they make any that bolt straight into the actual structure. So we've got these ones that go over the side. Okay, I've constructed one, and you use this table, and you see it's Toyota Hilux, and then it gives you X, Y, A, and B. So X and Y correlates to where it's going to sit on top of the van, and A and B is something like distances from the windows, like that. So you take your X and Y measurement. In this case, it was 109, and the other one is 111. You put this strip in, cut it, put it in. A little bit of strip on the end, put the ends on. Put this thing on, and a little rubber foot under there. And we'll do the same with the other one. A, in the instructions, is the measurement from here to the center of that. And then B is from the center of that to the center of that. Now B in this case is 72 centimeters, and I've actually extended it. I want it a bit longer than that, and I've gone to 95, so I've altered this slightly. But that's on there, that's pretty cool. And then you have this cover held in by this little pin thing, and I won't use them for a bit. I'll let them settle, and then I'll come back and just make sure they're tight enough. So the last thing I'm gonna do is, because I've only got one mud flap, I'm gonna take this off for the time being. It's not a great fit anyway. I'm gonna do it with the aid of a totally unsuitable set of spanners. Oh my God, something doesn't fit. No, 11 doesn't fit. It's 10 fit? That's the beauty of something so high up with such big wheel ground clearance, is you've got to take the wheels off to do it. There we go, that's better. For the time being anyway, it does need a pair of mud flaps, but very stiff is that one. We'll see what's out there. So that's it for the Hilux today. Here's a little taster of what we've got coming up. This is Dennis's brand new bumper. Well, brand new to him. Fog lights will go, we can sell those. And we can put some new spangly air vents in. Also, we have, for Freddy, look, hydraulic handbrake and other stuff. How cool. That's all coming up. But I said in the beginning of this video that I didn't quite have a name for the Hilux, and I've been thinking, and I thought of one. Maximus. How cool. I've called him Maximus after Maximus Iron Thumper, one of my favourite YouTubers, so that's very cool. So until the next time, there are, if you've made it this far and you've enjoyed what you've seen, there are channel memberships available. Join the rest of the complete legends that have joined me as members. it's like from 99p or something. That goes a long way to helping me purchase this stuff. And who knows what else. So if you want to join them, that's fantastic. You don't have to. A like on this video would be superb. Share it with your friends. But until the next time, as ever, thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for being there. Goodbye.